Everyone, my name is Lauren Walker, and I'm a junior at Southern University, and my major is social work. Today, I will be speaking about addictive behaviors and treatments. What is an addiction? According to Wikipedia, a behavioral addiction is a form of addiction that involves a compulsion to engage in a rewarding non-drug related behavior, sometimes called a national reward, despite any negative consequences to the person's physical, mental, social, or physical well-being. Alcohol addiction. According to the 2015 National Survey on Drug Use and Health, 86.4% of people ages 18 or older reported that they drink alcohol at some point in their lifetime. Alcohol poisoning. Most people die of alcohol poisoning are mostly men. The percentage of men is 76% and for women is 24%. According to the Center for Disease Control, an average of 6 people die of alcohol poisoning each day in the U.S. Very high levels of alcohol in the body can shut down many critical areas of the brain that control your breathing, heart rate, and also your body temperature. Which may result in death. There are many health issues with people who drink a lot of alcohol, such as heart diseases, cancer, which is such as the liver, the breast, and also mouth. You can also have seizures when you have drank a lot of alcohol, which is not very good at all. It can also cause high blood pressure problems as well when you consume a lot of alcohol. My article also states that it can affect the brain, the heart, the liver, and also the immune system. Alcohol interferes with the brain's communication pathways and can also affect the way the brain lacks, looks, and also works. An estimated 88,000 people, approximately 62,000 men and 26,000 women die from alcohol-related causes annually, making alcohol the fourth leading preventable cause of death in the United States. In 2014, alcohol-impaired driving accounted for 9,967 deaths. 31% of overall driving. There are many treatment options that can help someone who is very alcohol and also consumes a lot of alcohol. These treatments also consist of behavioral treatment, and that is, it can help the individual by changing their drinking habits through counseling. By having one-on-one counseling, this may allow the addict to receive the individual attention that they may need, which means that they don't always have to go to an alcohol bottle to help them with their issues or if they're going through depression, anxiety, or any other type of physical depression. Also, medication can also help an individual to stop drinking or also consume a least amount of alcohol without reappointment. Also, another treatment option can also be support groups such as AA or other 12-step programs that may help the individual to try and quit or cut back drinking with help of others. rehabilitation programs, rehab programs have a high success rate of sobriety for those suffering with addiction. According to the National Institute on Drug Abuse, men, more than 23% of admission to public rehab programs are due to alcohol abuse. Rehab programs have been proven for decades to be very, very successful, and it has helped millions of Americans overcome many addictions. Also, another help will be family encouragement. Family is another treatment program that can also help an individual who has suffered from alcoholism and also has a problem to help stop drinking or quit drinking or control their drinking habits. For example, a spouse can help by talking to the individual, why they are sober. Try and talk to them about different methods that they can take instead of turning to a bottle every time they have a problem that's wrong with them. They can also tell them how alcohol can also harm their body and also their mind, their physical health, and also their soul. They also have community engagement, which is by getting the addict to be involved in the community. This may help them recover faster by having the people they are in contact with on the daily basis on their main supporters. Also, they can go to church, which can help an individual to try and drink less or quit drinking. If you go to church, you can be cool with a lot of church members who can also help an individual by bringing them to their treatment programs and also bring them to different church events. Also, by getting involved in the community, the addict will feel like they are a part of something bigger than themselves. The 12-step program. 12-step program is a free program, which is a support group that helps the individual try to eliminate drinking with the help of their alcohol. By being in a group, the addict may feel a sense of brotherhood and unity. Rehab program statistics. According to the National Institute on Drug Abuse, more than 23% of admissions to public rehab programs are due to alcohol. 25 to 29 years old is a 14.8%, whereas the ages 20 to 24 is a 14.8%. And then the last one, ages 40 to 44, is a 12.6%. It helps a lot of these ages to help them stop drinking or also quit drinking. A group treatment. Support groups with other addicts can help the addict improve by giving the addict a feeling of family life, and they can also improve their addiction if they understand that there are other people who are also struggling with addiction. My final thoughts about alcohol is that many people feel like they are alone in their addictions, and as a result, they have no hope. Addiction is a very powerful force that can ruin families and also destroy people's lives. Fortunately, addicts are not alone, and there are many available treatment options for those who seek a better life. In my opinion, I feel that if you have anxiety, depression, or anything that's wrong with you, you should not at all control alcohol as a use. If you need someone to talk to, you can go to a family member, as stated in the PowerPoint. You can also turn to a friend, a very good relative, and also a church member. If they don't try to help you, then you can turn to a rehab program, as stated in my PowerPoint and also my article. It's a it helps a lot of people ages 20 through 25, 40 through 44, and also help them by they don't drink a lot, and also they do not always have to turn to a bottle of alcohol. So if you have any problem, feel free to even have to pray about it, but don't turn to a bottle of alcohol every chance you take. Just because if you consume a whole lot of alcohol, it can also mess up your brain and your heart, your liver, your cancer, your stomach, your kidney area, and also cause a lot of failure. So, that's all my final thoughts about alcohol. Is there any question that anyone would have to ask? And again, my name is Lauren Walker. Thank you for your time and thank you for your patience. Are there any other questions? Are there any other questions about alcohol treatment programs? What to do about alcohol?